So you're coming off back-to-back wins. How does it feel, and what are your thoughts?
I mean, it's good for us to progress forward. We had different people step up today that was really, really nice to see. And hopefully we can take that into tomorrow when we face Cal.
How are you going to bring the energy from today into tomorrow?
Well, we talked about being there for each other. And we saw that after every break, after the 50 free into the 100 free. We had a 15-minute break there, and the girls came out and were excited, and we had a victory in that next event. Same thing with the next break. Coming into the 200 IM, we were able to go 1-2-3. So we need to keep that energy and make sure we're focused on that.
You talk a lot about team culture. Can you just talk about how it plays a factor into meets like this?
It's a huge factor. And for people that don't think it's a factor, you can see the people that are buying in, the fun that we're having, the fast times we're doing right now in season, in our peak training. I just think that's all that we need to focus on right now. And so for us having, you know, Taylor McCoy win multiple events, you have McKenzie, our breaststroke core, really step up. Is huge, and then having Sophia decide to win the 100 butterfly was definitely a nice addition as well.
Were there any pleasant surprises that came out of this meet?
Like I said, Sophia deciding to step up and win the 100 fly and in-season best time. McKenzie winning the 2 breaststroke and in-season time. We were working on a little more mechanical technique, tempo issues with her, and she put it together in the first event, which is normally her tougher event all the way through. So. You know, as far as that's concerned, really excited for our crew, for our program. And, you know, we had a couple of changes in our lineup, but they rolled with it, and we did awesome. So very proud of them today.
Awesome. Thanks, Coach. Congrats.
Thank you, and go Cougs.